Hey guys, welcome back. Thanks for joining us today on The King of Random. A lot of people find the sound of running water very soothing and relaxing, but it's not always practical to have water running inside. So today we're going to try to build our own desktop fountain with a twist to it. The supplies for this build are surprisingly simple. We've got some clear plastic solo cups, another container that holds about twice as much liquid as the solo cups, some bendy straws, a plastic lid or plate, and of course a pump to drive the water. I've also got a glue gun, which I'll be using to do a lot of the assembly on this build. I've got a couple of extra supplies here, but I am actually only just going to use one cup and one straw, so I'll set the extras aside. This container that I'm using is one I picked up at Walmart for just a few bucks. It actually has a lot more on it than we need. We won't be using the lid or any of the attaching hardware. I just like the size and the shape of this and the fact that it's clear so you can see what I'm doing as I work on it. So the first step is I'm going to remove all of the excess hardware from our container. Here's the basic setup of how this is going to work. This larger container will hold our water and the pump will be down inside that. Our lid or plastic plate will go on top of that and our solo cup will go on top of our plate. Our drinking straw will connect to the pump, come up through the plastic plate and through the plastic cup. The water will be pumped into the cup at an angle, spraying around in circles. There will be another small hole in the center of the cup where the water will be draining out. Hopefully, if everything goes well, we'll get sort of a vortex effect as the water is filling up and draining at the same time. What we want to do now is drill two holes into the bottom of our solo cup, one right in the center and one much closer to the edge. For the hole in the very center of the cup, we want a drill bit that's about 3/4 the diameter of our straw. I'm going to be using a 3/16 inch drill bit. Next, we want to take a drill bit that's the exact same diameter of our straw and drill a second hole much closer to the edge of the cup. With the straws I'm using, a 15/64 inch drill bit is the perfect size. If you've used the right size of drill bit, your straw should fit into the hole and be pretty snug. If it's not a perfect fit, don't worry too much. We are going to be using some hot glue to attach the straw, and that will help by filling in some gaps as well. Now that we've got two holes drilled into the bottom of our cup, we want to drill two corresponding holes into our plastic lid. This plastic lid has a small bump in the center, so we'll line up the hole in the center of our cup with that mark. Now using a Sharpie, make a small mark on the plastic lid through the second hole in the cup. Now we're going to drill two holes into the plastic lid. They'll both be a little bit larger than the holes in the cup. For the center hole, I'm using a fairly large 1/2 inch drill bit. Scrap of wood so I don't drill holes into my table. This is so thin that it just started cutting right into the plastic immediately. So I'm just gonna clean that up with an X-Acto knife. For the second hole off to the side, I'm using a drill bit that's slightly larger than the diameter of our straw. This drill bit that I'm using is a 5/16 inch. That was a little better. Perfect, we can now set our cup on top of our lid and our holes line up wonderfully. One of them is going to be for the straw carrying the water up into the cup, and the other is a hole for it to drain out back into the main container. With those holes drilled, let's get ready to attach the straw to our cup. Before we attach the straw, we're going to trim off the section that feeds the water into our cup. Let's leave about 1/2 inch after the bendy elbow part. Now let's feed the bottom of the straw through the outside hole in the bottom of our cup. We want to push our straw all the way to the bottom of the cup. The part of the straw that we just cut short should be lined up with these ridges at the bottom. All right, we can see how we've got it lined up. Now for a second, we're just gonna pop it back out. Then we're going to apply some hot glue to the bottom of this part of the straw and then pull it back down and hold it in place until the glue cools. Now we also want to use a little bit of hot glue to go in a circle around the bottom where the straw is connected to the cup to make sure it's completely watertight. At this point, if you line the straw up with the outside hole in the lid, you can see how it's gonna start to fit together. Although, of course, at this point, with this container, our straw is too long, so we need to trim it back a little bit. I'm going to trim the straw back in two stages. First, I'm just gonna cut it short enough that it doesn't stop the cup from reaching the plastic plate. Then I'm going to put the pump in and line the straw up with where it's going to connect to that and cut it again. At this point, my straw is about 1 3/4 inch too long for my cup to rest on the plastic plate, so I'll cut that much off. That's better. Our cup now rests nicely on the plastic plate, just how we want it. However, our straw is going to connect to the output of our pump, and so it's going to need to be trimmed even more. Put the pump entirely inside the container, approximately lined up with the side hole in our plate. Resting our cup on the side of the container, we can then mark a spot at the same height as the output of our pump. I'm going to cut it a little bit below the line because a portion of the straw will actually fit inside the output tube of the pump. So we'll take the straw, run it through the outside drilled hole in our lid, and then we'll connect it to our pump. Then we can place the pump inside the lower container, and we can see how that is going to work. The pump will send water up the straw, which will spray out the straw at an angle, swirling around the cup. With the small hole in the middle, the water will drain down through that spot and hopefully give us a nice water vortex. Now, if everything goes correctly, the pump will be sending water into the cup faster than it's draining out the bottom, which will end up with water spilling over the top of the cup as well, which is one of the reasons we have this plastic tray here, and we need to make sure that it's a tray that has edges on it. Water will spill down into that, and to help it drain even faster, let's put a few more holes in it to drain down into our larger container below. It's not very important precisely where you put the holes, but they should be farther out than the diameter of the bottom of the cup and closer in than the edges of our large container. If you put them out on the very edges, then all of your water, of course, is going to run out onto your table. To drill these holes, I have to disconnect our cup from the pump, but I'm just gonna mark really quickly on the straw how far in it is because I think I've got it at a good height. For these drain holes, it doesn't matter a whole lot what size they are, but I like to try and keep them smaller, so I'm going back to our 3/16 inch drill bit. Sometimes the drilled holes are just a little bit messy. You can clean them up by just pulling the plastic off with your fingers, or in some cases, just use an X-Acto knife to carefully cut off the excess. Now there is another step that I want to take. Our fountain does run off of electricity, and of course that means it's got a cord coming off of it. If the cord comes up over the lip of the container, it will make our lid sit in a weird angle. If we're all right with the cord coming out of the top of a fountain, then we could just cut a small divot into the top where the cord could fit below the level of our lid. But I really like the look of the cord coming out of the bottom of the fountain. So what I'm going to do is drill a small hole in the bottom of our container. I'm then going to cut the power cord and fit it through that hole and then splice it back together so we have a complete cord running through the bottom of the fountain. There we go, that fits through pretty nicely. Rip off the rubber. There we have it. We now have our cord running out from the bottom of our fountain, which is just what we want. Now let's use some hot glue to secure that cord in place and seal up the hole so it's completely waterproof. I do want to leave a little bit of extra cord inside the container so that if we ever need to get our fountain out for any reason, we still have a little bit of room to play with it. Of course, if you're extremely patient, you can also use a silicone-based caulking that's designed for sealing up things like fish tanks, but those usually take a long time to cure, and I want to go a little bit faster than that. There we have it, our power cord is now attached, so it's time to add some water. Now first, I'm just going to add enough water that it covers this pump, and then I'm gonna plug it in so we can see the amount of power that this pump puts out. It's not very much. There you go. That's how much power we're getting out of our tiny little pump. We want to make sure the pump is completely covered and then take another cup, just like the one we're using in our fountain, and fill it all the way and pour that much water into our container as well. This way we know that no matter how much water is in our fountain above the pump, there will still be enough water to keep the pump completely covered, which is what it needs to keep pumping. In fact, I'm even going to add just a little bit more water, just to be safe. Looks like our seal is holding up beautifully. No water is leaking out, just what we want to see. Before we seal anything down, let's do a test attaching our straw to our pump through our lid and see what kind of effect we get when we turn on our pump. This is precisely one of those situations where I'm glad that I left enough cord that I can reach the pump. All right, so our straw goes down through our lid, put that into the output of our pump to the level we marked off. That lowers itself back down into the water. And now we'll plug it in. This type of pump doesn't have an on-off switch. It just runs whenever it's got power coming to it. So if you do want to be able to turn this on and off, you should use a power strip or another form of outlet that has a switch attached to it.
All right, here goes. 3, 2, 1. There we go. We can see we've got some good spinning in that water. Cup is filling up nicely as well. That's good. Strings of hot glue stuck to it, but that's not a huge problem. Beautiful, look at that. Fills all the way to the top of the cup, overflows over the edge, and we have that awesome little vortex going down through the middle of the cup. Fantastic, look at that. That works perfectly. Nice, relaxing, pouring water noises. Turn this off for a second.
Of course, as soon as we turn it off, it stops filling and just starts draining out the hole in the bottom. Now, our vortex fountain is working, but right now it doesn't look all that great. So now it's time to do a few decorations to make this thing look a lot more classy. Our plastic lid here doesn't look very fancy, so I'm gonna scuff it up lightly with some sandpaper and then paint it all black. Being able to see inside our container and watch the pump in action might be pretty interesting to some people, but I want to decorate it a little more than that. So I'm going to take some popsicle sticks and make a border that goes all the way around our lower container so it looks like a wooden planter box or something. Our popsicle sticks are just a tiny bit too tall. They'll be interfering with our plastic lid. So I'm going to trim a whole bunch of popsicle sticks down to a little bit shorter. Perfect. Now I just need to do that to like 50 more popsicle sticks. Now let's see how good my estimate was. I'm just gonna use the hot glue gun to attach these all the way around my container. This wedge shape at the top, I'm pretty sure it's because when I've been cutting these off, it makes the top of the popsicle stick flare just the tiniest bit. So they're all a little bit wider at the top and it's gotten me just this slight offset gap. So I'm just gonna cut this popsicle stick a little bit shorter and then I'm gonna use sandpaper and taper it down to that shape. Perfect. Our lower container has been lined with popsicle sticks that look like nice wooden slats. Our lid has been painted black, so let's attach them all together. I'm going to use hot glue to attach the cup to the lid, and then if you feel like it, you can attach the lid to the lower base. Although if you do that, it will be harder to get inside of your fountain if you ever need to in the future.
I am using some hot glue to attach the lid to the wooden popsicle sticks, but I'm only using a little bit so that if I do need to get into the fountain, it should be really easy to break through the hot glue seal holding it there. This will just keep it from shaking or moving if I accidentally bump it.
There we have it. It's now secured together fairly well, and just as one more decorative element, I've got some little pebbles that are too big to fit through any of my drain holes, and I'm just gonna set those around the cup so our fountain looks like it has a little bit more nature on it. All right, our fountain is all hooked up, ready to go and decorated. Let's plug it back in and see how this whole thing looks all together. It's a nice tornado. I like that tornado. Now, one more thing that I'm gonna try, just because I think it can be fun, is I'm gonna add one drop of blue food coloring to our water. Let's see what happens.
That's really cool. For a second, it just kind of holds the blue dye near the whirlpool.
Then the dye gets down into the base, the pump picks it up, and now it's just evenly distributed throughout the whole thing. So a slightly blue vortex water tornado maelstrom fountain. I don't know what to call it. Take your pick. There you go, a quick and easy way to build a very cool looking Vortex desktop fountain. It provides nice relaxing sounds. It looks pretty sweet with all the swirling water, the bubbles in it, and the little column of twisted air running down through the middle. For this project, I have been using what's just about the smallest volume of aquarium pump available. If you do use something with a little more power, the water will spin faster and the vortex will actually open up a little bit, and you'll usually have some water pouring off more parts of the cup at once. Coming up soon, we're gonna show you how to take this same idea and scale it up to a much larger vortex fountain, and we're also going to add a couple of fun twists to it. If you want to build this project, down in the description, we've provided a link where you can get one of these pumps. Thank you guys for joining us for this project today, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then. Oh my goodness. This thing can't cut electrical tape. Ugh, I don't know why it gets tiny little bubbles in it, but I'm so glad it does.